blessings to you. It's a great honor and a blessing to be here with you. Thank you, Pastor, for inviting me. And God's saints, thank you for having me. Every time I come here and spend time with you, whether I share the Word of God or I came and just attended one of your services, it's a great blessing. I don't understand your language, but I just love listening to your songs and whatever someone is speaking here, announcing or whatever. It's so beautiful. When we come to heaven, all of us will understand each other's language.
Amen.
No translator, no interpreter.
Full
understanding. Can you imagine? I'll be able to speak Farsi. And you'll be able to speak Tigrinya.
Yeah.
Praise God. Yes, praise God. Today I'd love to speak about divine placement and the mission of God. We'll be looking into Ruth's life and the journey that happened in her life. So we'll go to the book of Ruth. And we'll read from there. Okay, let's just be patient, a little bit patient, and just try to grasp what exactly is happening in the first chapter.
و مردی از بیت لحم یهودا رفت تا در بلاد موآب ساکن شود او و زنش و دو پسرش و اسم آن مرد علی ملک بود و اسم زنش نعومی و پسرانش به محلوم و کلیون مسما و افراتیان بیت لحم بودند پس به بلاد موآب رسیده در آنجا ماندند و علی ملک شوهر نعومی مرد مرد و او با دو پسرش باقی ماند و ایشان از زنان موآب برای خود زن گرفتند که نام یکی عرفه و نام دیگری بود و در آنجا قریب به 10 سال توقف نمودند و هر دوی ایشان محلوم و کلیون نیز مردند و آن زن از دو پسر و شوهر خود محلوم ماند پس او با دو عروس خود برخاست تا از بلاد موآب برگردند زیرا که در بلاد موآب شنیده بود که خداوند از قوم خود تفقد نموده نان به ایشان داده است و از مکانی که در آن ساکن بود بیرون آمد و دو عروسش همراه وی بودند و به راه روانه شدند تا به زمین یهودا مراجعت کنند و نعومی به دو عروس خود گفت بروید و هر یکی از شما به خانه مادر خود برگردید و خداوند بر شما احسان کند چنان که شما به مردگان و به من کردید و خداوند به شما عطا کند که هر یکی از شما در خانه شوهر خود راحت یابید. پس ایشان را بوسید و آواز خود را بلند کرده گریستند و به او گفتند نه بلکه همراه تو نزد قوم تو خواهیم برگشت. نعومی گفت ای دخترانم برگردید چرا همراه من بیایید؟ آیا در رحم من هنوز پسران هستند که برای شما شوهر باشند؟ ای دخترانم برگشته راه خود را پیش گیرید، زیرا که برای شوهر گرفتن زیاده پیر هستم و اگر گویم که امید دارم و امشب نیز به شوهر داده شوم و پسران هم بزایم، آیا تا بالغ شدن ایشان صبر خواهید کرد و به خاطر ایشان خود را از شوهر گرفتن محروم خواهید داشت؟ نه دخترانم، زیرا که جانم برای شما بسیار تلخ شده است، چون که دست خداوند بر من دراز شده است. پس بار دیگر آواز خود را بلند کرده گریستند و عرفه مادر شوهر خود را بوسید، اما روت به وی چسبید و او گفت اینک زن برادر شوهرت نزد قوم خود و خدایان خیش برگشته است، تو نیز در عقب زن برادر شوهرت برگرد. روت گفت بر من اصرار مکن که تو را ترک کنم و از نزد تو برگردم، زیرا هر جایی که رو می آیم و هر جایی که روی می آیم و هر جایی که منزل کنی منزل می کنم. قوم تو قوم من و خدای تو خدای من خواهد بود. جایی که بمیری میمیرم و در آنجا دفن خواهم شد. خداوند به من چنین بلکه زیاد بلین کند که اگر چیزی غیر از موت مرا از تو جدا نماید. پس چون دید که او برای رفتن همراهش مصمم شده است، از سخن گفتن با وی باز ایستاد و ایشان هر دو روانه شدند تا به بیت لحم رسیدند. و چون وارد بیت لحم گردیدند، تمامی شهر بر ایشان به حرکت آمده. زنان گفتند که آیا این نعومی است؟ او به ایشان گفت مرا نعومی مخوانید، بلکه مرا مرده بخوانید، زیرا قادر مطلق بر من مرارت سخت بسانیده است. من پر بیرون رفتم و خداوند مرا خالی برگردانید، پس برای چه مرا نعومی میخوانید؟ چون که خداوند مرا ذلیل ساخته است و قادر مطلق به من بدی رسانیده است. و نعومی مراجعت کرد و عروسش روت معابیه که از بلاد معاب برگشته بود همراه وی آمد و در ابتدای درویدن جو وارد بیت لحم شدند.
Shall we pray?
میخوام دعا کنیم.
Heavenly Father, we thank you and we bless your precious name.
خداوند آسمانی، تو رو شکر میکنیم و نام تو رو جلال میدیم.
Lord, we ask and come before you.
ما میخوام از تو امروز درخواست کنیم.
To bless your word, Father God, and speak to each and every one of us this evening.
که با کلام مقدس خودت با قلب تک ما امروز صحبت کنیم.
Help us, Father God, to really understand your word with the revelation of the Holy Spirit.
به ما کمک کن که کلام تو رو، حقیقت کلام تو رو با توانایی روح القدس خودت بفهمی.
Lord, we don't want to be religious people, but people of life.
خداوند، ما نمیخوام آدم‌های مذهبی باشیم، بلکه می‌خوایم آدم‌هایی که زنده هستن باشیم.
Lord, as I stand here before your precious people, help me.
خداوند، همونجور که اینجا در مقابل فرزندان تو هم، مقابل عزیزان ایستادم، به من کمک کن.
Help me to speak only your word and your word alone.
به من کمک کن که فقط و فقط کلام تو از زبانم خارج بشه.
In Jesus' name.
در نام عیسی مسیح.
Amen.
Amen.
I have two expectations to this evening. Number one, I will expect every one of us, including myself, to fall in love with the Lord more today than yesterday. Number two, I want everyone to listen to the Holy Spirit. Sometimes we listen to the preacher and miss the voice of the Holy Spirit. It's good to be impressed by someone speaking really well. But that physical impression does not get us anywhere. But when we hear the Holy Spirit, the voice of the Holy Spirit in our heart, then a true change comes into our life. Into our life. A real change comes into our life. Now, as we read from the Bible, the book of Ruth, we see in chapter 1 that there was a certain man by the name Elimelech. And then he, because of the drought that was going on around that time, he decided to leave Bethlehem, Judea, and go his way to Moab. In my introduction, I'd like to speak about his name. His name is Elimelech.
اسمش Elimelech.
Elimelech means God is my king.
Elimelech به این معنی این اسم یعنی خداوند پادشاه من است.
In other words, God is the ruler in my life.
یا در شکلی دیگه خداوند کنترل کننده زندگی من است.
In a different expression, I am a Christian, but Jesus doesn't have any rule in my life. Why am I saying that? Because his name is Elimelech, but he was led by the natural things that by his circumstances.
ولی اون شخص هم با اینکه اسمش علی ملک بود یعنی خداوند پادشاه من است ولی خودش هم داشت همون زندگی رو میکرد که هر کسی انجام میداد.
Being a born again Christian and trusting God.
اینکه یک مسیحی باشیم که تولد دوباره داره و یا یک کسی باشیم که به خداوند اعتماد داره.
Is totally different from being a religious person.
کاملا متفاوت با اینکه یک آدم مذهبی باشیم.
Our religiosity does not bring any life into our life.
مذهبی بودن هیچ حیاتی هیچ زندگی در قلب‌های ما در زندگی همون به وجود نمیاره.
As we say Jesus is Lord.
همونجوری که ما میگیم عیسی مسیح خداونده.
We have to live that out and we have to practice it in our everyday life.
ما باید همونجوری هم زندگی کنیم.
We have to allow God to be the king and the ruler in our life.
باید بذاریم خداوند پادشاه و کنترل کننده زندگی همون باشه.
Now we're talking about God's mission and divine placement.
ما داریم راجع به ماموریت خداوند و جایگزینی که اون از ما انجام میده در ماموریت خودش صحبت میکنه.
No one is an accident at all.
هیچ کسی تو این دنیا یک تصادف نیست.
God foreknew about you before the beginning of the world.
خداوند راجع به تک تک شما میدونست قبل از اینکه حتی دنیا رو خلق کنه.
God has a special plan for each and every one of you from the very beginning, before you even were born.
خداوند برای تک تک شما یک هدف مشخص داره حتی قبل از اینکه شما به دنیا بیاید همین هدف رو برای شما داشته.
Some of us might have been born because you know, even though your mom and dad were not really expecting some more babies or some more child.
شاید ما در شرایطی دنیا اومده باشیم که پدر مادر ما حالا در اون شرایط منتظر یک بچه نبودن یا بچه‌های بیشتری می‌خواستن.
That's only about your mom and dad.
اون فقط مادر پدر شما هستن.
But from God's perspective.
ولی از دید کتاب مقدس.
You did not come about by accident.
ولی شما از دید کتاب مقدس یک تصادف نبودید.
God has a special plan in your life.
Amen.
خداوند یک هدف مشخص در زندگی‌های شما داره.
So Elimelech did not really follow God's rule in his life.
ولی Elimelech برخلاف اسمش زیاد مسیر خداوند رو دنبال نمی‌کرد در زندگی.
He took his family to Moab.
اون خودش و خانواده‌اش رو به موآب برد.
And as a result of not following God and allowing God to be the ruler in his life.
و به خاطر اینکه نذاشت که خداوند کنترل کننده و پادشاه زندگیش باشه.
He died.
خودش مرد اول.
And his two sons died.
دو تا پسرش مردن.
And then there was no one left to carry on the family name or the inheritance.
دیگه هیچ کسی نبود که اسم اون خانوادگی رو اون نسل رو نگه داره.
In those days or any other day, it has a huge meaning to carry on the family name.
در اون زمان‌ها یا حتی الان هم خیلی این معنی بزرگی داره که اسم خانوادگی رو نگه داری و به نسل‌های بعد انتقال بدی. خیلی چیز بزرگی بود.
In the physical, maybe the name, but in God's perspective, it's God's inheritance, God's mission.
شاید به گوش ما فقط یه اسم بیاد ولی در اصل اون ماموریت خداست که به نسل‌های بعد انتقال داده میشه.
So sometimes when we mess up with God's plan in our life,
وقتی که ما بعضی وقتا اون مسیری رو که خداوند برای ما قرار داده دنبال نمی‌کنیم.
Because God is merciful.
خداوند خیلی رحیم و مهربونه.
And He comes and reveals Himself in our life with a plan B.
خودش رو توی یک شرایط دیگه و با یک هدف دیگه، هدف دومی میاد و در زندگی‌های ما قرار میده و ما نشون میده.
So now, just like Elimelech,
و الان دقیقاً مثل Elimelech,
if you think that you have messed up some of God's plan in your life,
و اگر احساس میکنید اون مسیر رو که خداوند برای شما قرار داده در بعضی از مقاطع زندگیتون دنبال نکردین,
I want to remind you that God is a merciful God and He has plan B for you.
میخوام به شما یادآوری کنم که خداوند ما خداوند خیلی رحیم و مهربونیه و اون یک برنامه دیگه برای شما قرار داده.
God's original plan is so beautiful.
اولین هدفی که خداوند برای ما داره، اولین نقشه‌ای که داره خیلی بزرگ و قشنگه.
But when we come before the Lord and ask Him for His mercifulness,
ولی وقتی که ما میایم به سمت خداوند و از اون میخوایم که ما رو ببخشه و به ما رحم کنه,
then He comes and reveals Himself with a plan B, which is so beautiful as well.
میاد و یک نقشه دیگر رو تو زندگی ما پیاده میکنه و که اون هم همینجور خیلی قشنگه.
So when these two sons of Elimelech,
وقتی که این دو تا پسر Elimelech,
they got married to Moabites,
با موآبها ازدواج کردن,
which is not really the right way to do as Israelites or God's people.
که چیز خیلی خوبی نبود و در واقع تو قوم اسرائیل نباید انجام می‌شد.
And they didn't have any children.
هیچ بچه‌ای هم نداشتن.
And both of them died.
و هر دوشون هم مردن.
So these two Moabite women, they were pretty close to their mother-in-law.
این دو تا زن موآبی خیلی به مادر شوهرشون نزدیک.
And then in that time, Naomi, the Elimelech's wife, she heard that God is visiting her people.
در اون موقع نعومی شنید که در مملکت خودش خداوند داره مردم اون مکان و اون قسمت رو ملاقات میکنه.
So she thought for herself, I'll go back home because I'm empty now. There's nothing for me in this country.
به خودش گفت پس بهتره که به سرزمین خودم برگردم چون اینجا دیگه هیچی ندارم و همه چیز برای من بی‌معنی اینجا.
I came to Moab with fullness.
من به موآب اومدم وقتی همه چیز داشتم.
And I'm empty-handed now.
و الان هیچ چیز ندارم.
So I better go back home and stay with my people.
پس بهتره الان برگردم خونه و حداقل با مردم خودم باشم.
And then she packed all her stuff and went her way with with the two daughter-in-laws.
پس چمدوناش رو بست و به راه افتاد با دو تا عروساش.
Ruth and Orpa.
که یکیشون عرفه و دیگری اسمش بود.
Yeah, so these two daughter-in-laws.
این دو تا عروس.
God is calling them in His divine plan.
خداوند داره صداشون میکنه که به اون نقشه آسمانیش بیان.
Just as the same way as God revealed Himself in each and every one of us life.
دقیقاً همونجوری که خداوند خودش رو به تک ما توی زندگی همون نشون داد.
So God came to Ruth and Orpah and calling them into His kingdom.
خداوند خودش رو به روت و عرفه هم نشون داد و اونها رو صدا کرد که به نقشه عظیم آسمانیش بپیوندن.
In a certain time, for each and every one of us, God's call came into our life and we obeyed and we took a step.
در یک قسمتی از زندگی همه ما انتخاب کردیم که خداوند رو پیروی کنیم و خداوند وارد زندگی های ما شد.
What we obeyed and came into is called the kingdom of God.
همون چیزی که ما اطاعت کردیم و وارد زندگی ما شد در واقع همون ملکوت و پادشاهی خداوند.
The Bible tells us, seek ye first God's kingdom and his righteousness.
کتاب مقدس ما میگه اول ملکوت و عدالت خدا را بطلبید.
When I read the Amplified Bible, it says it amplifies the word the kingdom of God.
وقتی که من ترجمه تفسیری کتاب مقدس رو خوندم این کلمه ملکوت رو برای من بیشتر باز کرد.
the way God does things. The way God does things. So for these two women, coming into Israel is not just going to a different country. It's obedience and coming into God's kingdom, which is the way God does things. All of us here, including myself, we used to live a life, a worthless life. I used to belong, my background is a different denomination, and when God called me, I obeyed and I came to know Christ. Maybe more for your people, you used to live a different life and you came to know the Lord. The most important thing and the biggest, the huge thing is not just changing our religion. It's recognizing God's kingdom and living the kingdom of God. Ruth and Orpah were invited to the kingdom of God and they obeyed at first. So it's not what we started that counts. What counts is our full obedience and fulfilling and achieving what God is expecting from us. So now everyone, these two women with their with the mother, with the mother-in-law, they left Moab and they are on their way. I don't know how far they've gone. So I think that Naomi, she realized it, that why am I taking these young women? I don't even know where to go and where, if I have a shelter or not. It's my country, I'll suffer, that's fine. But I don't want these two young women to come with me and suffer. So I think she stopped right in the middle of the road or in the wilderness. And then she started to convince them to go back to their mother's houses. But they seemed so determined and they started to cry out loud. And she continued pursuing them. And then at the end, Orpah, she said, okay, she went and she kissed her goodbye. You see, our faith will go through fire. Remember Jesus, he preached the gospel, he healed the sick, and he cast out the demons.
یادتون میاد وقتی که عیسی مسیح داشت خبر خوب رو موعظه میکرد، خبر انجیل رو موعظه میکرد، بیماران رو شفا میداد، روحهای پلید رو از انسانها بیرون میکرد.
And then at the end, he fed them. And then right the next day, they came back and they wanted to make him a king. I think they wanted to make him a king, not because they wanted a king, but they wanted to stop working because this guy is going to feed them every day. Two fish and five bread. Vacation for the rest of their life. And then he said, I know why you're trying to make me a king. It's because you ate. I am the bread of life that came from heaven. Without anyone without not eating me cannot make it to heaven. So almost everyone left him. But everyone was called to the kingdom of God. You see, all of us are called into God's kingdom, which is God's mission. But our faith goes through fire. You need to stand firm. Especially, I can imagine, I don't know your story, but I can imagine what kind of stress and pressure you guys could go because you have come closer to God.
من داستان تک شما رو نمیدونم ولی میتونم تصور کنم که چه فشارهایی رو تحمل کردیم به خاطر اینکه به خداوند نزدیک شدیم.
From your families, friends, relatives and everyone.
از دوستاتون، از خانوادتون و از همه اطرافیانتون.
Why? Why did you decide this? Why did you leave your religion? Why?
که ازتون میپرسن چرا مذهب خودت رو ترک کردی؟ چرا به همچین تصمیمی رسیدی؟
Being isolated.
که شما رو ترک میکنم و تنها میذارم.
Maybe they hate you. They don't know. They don't want to see you again. That's a huge price to pay. But it is necessary that your faith goes through fire. I mean, God is not just calling us and, you know, trying to convince us, it's okay, come on, just go on.
خداوند فقط ما رو صدا نکرده که بگه اوکی خب باشه همه چیز خوبه رد شو همینجوری برو.
God even expects us to pay a price, a heavy price.
حتی خداوند از ما توقع داره که ما یک بها پرداخت
کنیم. One of my friends, a pastor, an Eritrean pastor.
یکی از دوستای من که یک کشیشه.
God called him to go to Yemen and Saudi Arabia, but he's in Yemen right now.
خداوند اون رو خوند که بره به یمن و عربستان سعودی.
And he's preaching the gospel. Many people, many Yemenis are coming to know the Lord. And these Yemeni people, because of their religious background, they're coming from Islam. So they're paying a huge price. One of the men that came to know Christ, a group of people from Al-Qaeda were threatening him. And we're going to kill you, we're going to kill you. And he sent them back a message, I'm ready. About a month and a half ago, they came to his house, pulled him out from the house, and killed him right in front of his wife and his children. As they were killing him, he was praying for them, blessing them. Faith to the point of death.
ایمان تا نقطه مرگ.
knowing Christ to the point of death. But Orpah's case, that wasn't it, because she was convinced enough. She not really stood firm. She kissed her mother-in-law, went back. Where did she go back to? She went back to Moab, where people worship idols. People worship demons. An ugly lifestyle that does not even glorify God at all. But Ruth, she understood what the calling of God in her life is. And she decided to go her way as she started. She said to her mother-in-law, I will go with you, please don't push me back. Your people will be my people. Your God will be my God. I will die where you die. And I'll be buried where you'll be buried. That's a covenant. With God. With God's people. And with her mother-in-law. Okay, so she understood going with her mother-in-law is accepting God's mission. I believe she did not decide here in her mind. She made the decision right under here in her heart. Because she was so determined. Many times, if not all the time, we understand with our intellect, but we can't understand the spirit realm with our intellect. We sense and we receive God's call in our spirit. So I'm 100% sure that she was sensing something in her spirit that God has prepared for her. She is following a very poor, empty-handed mother-in-law. She could have thought that why am I going with this poor lady? But it was not about the poor lady. It's about God and God's call. Then they went on and they arrived in Bethlehem. When they arrived there, there was a harvest season. But it doesn't really matter because they don't have any field or they don't have any harvest of themselves. So Ruth didn't just expect her mother-in-law to go out and beg someone for food and bring and feed her. She told her mother-in-law, let me go. Bless me to go out and glean in the field and come back with some food. And so she did and started gleaning. God's call might start with from scratch.
And
so it is most of the time like that. We have to trust God. I mean, everything belongs to God, right? Gold and silver and everything in this world.
God
could bless you with anything, anytime, anyone, anytime you want it, just like that. But God really expects us to walk with Him by faith. God knows what's awaiting her, and she senses it, but she went out gleaning. Gleaning is in those days it was just like just having going to a social services and get some money.
خداوند برای روح اون موقع یک نقشه داشت و اون روح اینو تو قلبش احساس می‌کرد ولی در اون لحظه چیزی رو نمی‌تونست ببینه فقط رفت و یه سعی کرد یه سری محصولات رو که داشتن اونجا درو می‌کردن جمع کنه برای خوردن این تقریبا توی اگه بخوام معنیش کنیم به همین زمان یه جورایی مثل اینی که بری کارهای برای مثلا مردم یه سری کارها انجام بری یه ذره پول ناچیزم بهت بدن
Poor people, they go out to the field and they glean. And the harvesters, they don't like them. They chase them out. Because most of the time, they steal from the harvest.
چون که خیلی وقتا میشد که اون که اون آدمی که میمدن جمع کنن از اون محصول اصلی هم چیزایی میدزدیدن.
But in Ruth's case,
ولی برای روت
she went into a certain man's field by the name Boaz.
روت رفت به زمین یک مرد به اسم بواز.
In the natural, it seems that she went into that field by accident.
برای ما ممکنه اینجور به نظر برسه که اون که خیلی تصادفی وارد اون زمین شد.
But what happened is that because she trusted God and she was trusting the Lord in her walk.
ولی در واقع چون اون به عیسی به خداوند اعتماد کرده بود و داشت با این اعتماد راه می‌رفت.
And even though it seemed like an accident in the natural.
با اینکه شاید به دید خیلی یا تصادف به نظر برسه.
But in God's plan it was well arranged and engineered by God. Jesus' disciples, they asked Jesus, John the Baptist is teaching his disciples how to pray. You also teach us how to pray. And Jesus started to teach them and comparing how the Pharisees pray and the others should pray and how they should pray. And he taught them what we know today, the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. That will be done on earth as it is in heaven and so on. I don't know in Farsi, but it would not be really too long, but in English or in any other language in average, that prayer takes about 40 seconds. So is Jesus teaching them your prayer life should be just 40 seconds a day? The answer is no. Jesus was teaching them guideline of how to pray. He didn't say pray this. He said, but when you pray, And then he taught them that prayer. So it's a guideline. So our Father in heaven, could one person could pray this for 15 minutes or half an hour or maybe an hour. Just our Father in heaven. You are my Father.
همین کلمه خداونده با که در آسمانی یک نفر میتونه برای ساعت‌ها فقط روی این یک کلمه یک جمله دعا کنه.
And then he can worship God. Hallowed be thy name. And then he can worship God for another hour.
و میتونه پرستش کنه نام تو مقدس باد و یک ساعت دیگه هم فقط پرستش کنه و بگه خداوند نام تو مقدس.
So put every one hour in each guideline.
پس در واقع اگه این دعای ربانی رو یک فهرست در نظر بگیریم یه هر کدومش یه هر جمله‌اش میشه یک ساعت موند و دعا کرد.
Okay, what I wanted to say is here now is that one of the guidelines.
در واقع چیزی که اینجا میخوام بگم اینه که توی یکی از همین نکته ها توی دعای ربانی.
It says, "Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven."
اراده تو چنان که در آسمان است در زمین نیز کرده شود.
This is the core point in my message today.
این یک چیز کلیدی و اصلیه در موعظه‌ای که من دارم امروز براتون می‌خونم.
If you missed everything I said.
اگه هر چیزی که تو الان گفتم رو نفهمیدین.
I don't want you to miss this.
این رو نمی‌خوام از دست بدین.
Now listen carefully.
خیلی با دقت گوش بدین.
Now listen very closely.
خیلی با دقت گوش بدین.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
اراده تو چنان که در آسمان است در زمین نیز کرده شود.
Now in the beginning I reminded you that I expected to really get a revelation from God.
در آغاز به شما گفتم که من از شما توقع خواهم داشت که امروز یک مکاشفه جدید از خدا.
This is the right time to talk to the Holy Spirit. Speak to me. Let me get this by the revelation.
دقیقاً این الان زمانش هست که شما میتونید از روح القدس سوال کنید و از اون بخواید که این مکاشفه را امروز به شما بده.
So now I've already told you that no one is an accident. You're not an accident. You're not. No one is an accident.
This
means that God has a special plan for each and every one of you right here.
این به این معنی که خداوند برای تک تک شما ها که اینجا هستین یک نقشه داره.
You're not called in masses.
همینجوری به شکل چند نفری شما خوانده نشد.
God knows you. God knows about you personally and he has a special plan for you, especially for you. I'm talking an individual, everyone.
خداوند به طور شخصی شما رو میشناسه و به طور شخصی برای هر کدوم از شما نقشه داره. کلی صحبت نمی‌کنم.
Now Jesus is teaching his disciples in the guideline of prayer to pray, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Okay, listen carefully again. Now God has a special plan for you in heavens, in the throne room.
خداوند برای تک تک شما یک نقشه و یک جای به خصوص در ملکوت داشته.
But it doesn't happen just accidentally.
ولی خیلی تصادفی انجام نخواهد شد، اتفاق نخواهد
افتاد. It is your responsibility to download God's will into your life.
این مسئولیت شماست که این اراده خداوند رو در زندگی هاتون بگیرید، دریافتش کنید.
In the end of days, when if Jesus comes back or if we die, you know, in due season. We will not have any case to accuse God. You promised me this and that, but nothing happened really. God will show you, this was my plan for you. But you didn't download it to earth. It was your responsibility to download my plan for you and to walk accordingly. According to it. So Ruth, she understood this principle. That's why she went and doing started to do something. God had a special divine placement for her at Boaz's field. You are here at the Spirit of Truth Church, not by accident, but by God's plan. I know pastor's responsibility is to encourage you, but it is your responsibility to download God's plan into your life. Many believers, they accuse their brothers and sisters around them and their pastors and the ministers. We need to be responsible enough to download God's plan, God's special plan in our life and download it. When I bought this this device, it only had just the basic functions. But it was my responsibility to buy or download some apps and softwares into
this.
We are, all of you, every one of us here, we are just with basic functions on this earth. And we're just like the hardware. It will be our responsibility to download God's software into our hardware. If you buy this device, it will not come with Farsi script. In order for you to use it to write in Farsi, you have to buy or download the app, whether it's free or you have to buy it. It's the same principle with God. God has a book, a software for you. You don't know what it is until you download it.
Ask
God, what's my mission? In your mission. I want to live a meaningful life. I just don't want to have a life of just going to church back and forth every Sunday and then nothing else happens. Bless me and make me a blessing. I want to be a blessing to my brothers and sisters. I want to be a blessing to my neighbors. I want to be a blessing in your kingdom. Download your software into my hardware. That's exactly what happens to Ruth. She was just humbly gleaning. Collecting some leftovers. And then God blessed her with favor. Boaz came. And then he asked who she was. And the harvesters, they told him, this is a woman who came from Moab with her mother-in-law. And he was so pleased with because of what she did. He blessed her with lots of grain. So Ruth wasn't just a beggar. God's blessing started to flow into her life because she started she understood the principle. She downloaded God's idea, God's plan in her life, God's software into her life. She could have said, you know, I'm a foreigner here, you know, I'm a refugee, I'm a foreigner. I don't know the language. I don't know the culture. I don't have any connections. And I just need to go to the welfare system. But she didn't do that. She understood God's principle. And when she did, she grabbed it. She downloaded it into her life. And started to walk in it. So when she went back to her mother-in-law, her mother-in-law was so happy. She was surprised. And then she told her where she was, and she explained in a certain man's field by the name Boaz. Now Naomi didn't tell Ruth where to go, which field to go. You know, this is the owner is so and so, and the address is here and here and there. She didn't say that. She just blessed her. And then the Lord started blessing her. So now Naomi told Ruth, "Oh, if it's Boaz, he is our relative." So I'll tell you what to do. You go and I'll tell you what to do. So she told her, when he sleeps in the field, look where he sleeps. And open where he sleeps, and just sleep underneath his feet. And Ruth, she followed that instruction. Did the same thing. When he woke up in the morning, he saw her right there. And he told her exactly what to do. Please read the whole story and you will find out that Ruth became his wife. And then as a result, she became pregnant. God blessed her with a child. And that child was David's grandfather. And whose father is Jesus? I mean, David. Whose grandfather is David? Everyone that prays that was asking Jesus, have mercy, son of who? Who is Jesus' great grandmother?
Yeah.
It's Ruth. How did that happen? Because she obeyed and downloaded God's software into her life. So if you want God, Jesus, to be glorified in your life, download God's software into your life. That's the mission of God in your life. Let's pray. Holy Father, we thank you and we bless your precious name. Lord, I pray for this congregation and each and everyone, Father. So that everyone will be able to download your software. So everyone will have the power to obey you, Father God, and live your the life in your kingdom. I release your anointing upon each one. In Jesus' name.
در نام عیسی مسیح.
آمین.
آمین.